Welcome to Paramita Tidit Club. Tongue, a boon and bane. Tongue, an organ that helps us to express our feelings, thoughts, etc. I mean, our thoughts come through it in the form of words. Words of affection, melodious songs, speeches that are historical, and many articulations are slipped out of the tongue. In the above cases, there is no tongue slip, but good things slip out of the tongue. If anything slips out of the tongue, it is for making something, but if tongue itself slips, it is for breaking. I repeat, if anything slips out of the tongue, it is for making something, but tongue itself slips, it is for breaking. Hope you understood, tongue slip leads to conflict between the people. So we have to think before we speak. Just think, how many times do you think before you speak? Just recollect, did you face any problem when you spoke without thinking? That created problem for you and also for others. Let me share you one thing which you may know, but I am just reinforcing that incident. One day there was an accident and the boy was seriously injured. The parents of the child brought him to the hospital. That was an emergency case and the boy was in need of immediate surgery. The doctor was not available on the spot. The worried parents were shouting at the hospital staff for non-availability of doctor and delay in his coming. The doctor came running into the hospital after some time, was panting. The angry parents questioned the doctor, "Don't you have common sense? Don't you have seriousness? My child is struggling for life and you made such delay." The doctor did not react but said, "Don't worry, your child will be safe." The parents did not stop saying and said, "My child is struggling for life and you made such delay. If your child would be in this condition, you would understood our worry." The doctor said nothing but went straight to the operation theater. After an hour, he came out and said, "Don't worry, relax. The operation was successful and the child was safe." And he told, "Take other information from hospital staff," and hurried out. The parents went to the nurse and said, "Is he a doctor, at least a human being?" Not even responding to her words, he went running. The nurse broke into tears and said, "Don't say so." Because the son of a doctor died on spot in today's morning accident. Soon after your arrival, we informed our doctor about your child's condition so that he stopped his son's death rituals and came here, as only he can do this critical surgery. The parents were shocked and repented like anything. But what is the use? Hence, never ever slip your tongue. Think before you speak. I repeat, never ever slip your tongue. Think before you speak. Our words have so much of power that they can give life to others and sometimes they can take the life. Our words can build up others and sometimes they can tear them off. Wrong words which are uttered not only spoils others but also spoil your own life. For example, wrong words used by King Nanda brought down his great kingdom. King Nanda censured Acharya Chanakya and invented troubles. Chanakya, with the help of Chandragupta, collapsed Nanda dynasty. Because of tongue slip of King Nanda, slipped his great kingdom. Dear friends, remember that our tongue slip not only spoils others, but also bring damage to our own life. I repeat, our tongue slip not only damages others, but also bring spoil to our own life. Let me share you my own story. When I was in my 7th and 8th standard, I did not have any control over my tongue. I even faced some problems too. On one day, in my parent-teacher meeting, one of my teachers told to my mother that I would face some problems in my future because of my words. One fine day, I realized that and I had a victory over my tongue. Now, I am the master of my tongue, not tongue my master. And when I was in 9th grade, the same teacher told to my mother that she was taking all her previous words back, as I am very sensible before I speak. Why don't people think before they speak? When I tried to change my habit, I finally realized that impatient listening leads to tongue slip. Yes. If one is patient listener, he can't speak senselessly. Listen first before reacting. First listen and then speak. I repeat, first listen and then speak. Because let not your words cause for conflict. The words shot by our tongue can't be take back, can't be brought back. Let me share how society is being impacted by tongue slip. Families are getting separated because of this. In many of the divorce cases, tongue played a major role. Many innocent children are suffering as they can't introduce mother, father for their friends when others are doing the same. Coming to property division, 9 out of the 10 families are getting separated because of the words used in the process of property division. The words which are shot without much care, and there one can find fighting between the siblings for property. What does property give them? Does it give life, happiness, health? But loving words of siblings bring enduring happiness which curb all this illness. I just want to tell that tongue slip is breaking down the families and societies. Our word can build up glorious society. It's in our hand that, our tongue's hand that, whether we want heaven or hell. My sincere appeal to all, let your mind be gate for words. Before you utter a word, the word should come out of 3 gates. Gate 1, is it true? Gate 2, is it necessary? Gate 3, is it kind? I repeat, gate 1, is it true? Gate 2, is it necessary? Gate 3, is it kind? So guys, think before you speak, because your words can build up beautiful surroundings. Every Sankranti celebration reminds us, take a sugar and have a sweet talk. Thank you.